How about Philadelphia, Montreal? Oh. You ready?
You know, for a month I've been waiting for this game. I went out and watched the warm-up, and I didn't go out to watch a brawl or anything like that.
Or start one.
You could just feel it. You can feel it out there. Now, the players' faces, you know, some games the guys are kind of in the warm-up, they're falling asleep and that. You can just feel it. They were up along the red line. They're behind to one another. Nobody was given an inch, I'll tell you. I guarantee you this will be a good game tonight. I guarantee it.
Canadians with a man advantage now. Their penalty has been served, and here's a chance. Richard! What a play! Stick making contact up high, so it's called. Went off the stick of Marcow up high. Mellenby and Lemieux had a word or two.
Yeah, Lemieux got the first shot in, and Mellenby retaliated.
Huffman to Howe. Back to Huffman. He's going to shoot it there. No, he isn't. He passes off. Kopp drives it. That's knocked down at the goal crease. Oh, what a save by Patrick Roy. Brilliant save by Patrick Roy. I'll tell you, he is up for this game.
Watch it here. Roy. Oh, his glove hit the mesh. I don't know about that one.
20 seconds left in the penalties. This place will go crazy if they keep Philadelphia off the scoreboard. They have another 10 seconds to kill. Here's Sinisalo coming in. Sinisalo waits, steps in the proper area for a shot. Now Howe, stop! It's setting a breakaway. They're out of the box and away they go. Lemieux, Smith, scores!
Can you believe it?
Listen to this crowd. .52 the time of that goal, and the Canadians come for more. Nyland, rebound on the goal line. It did not go in. It got to the goal line. Somehow it was stopped. You would swear the puck was rolling in. And now we're going to go.
Two Canadians without helmets. Two non-fighters, really. Mats Näslund, of all people. And Guy Carboneau. I don't think anything more is going to come of this. Had there been a little more moxie on the shot by Carboneau, it would have been over the line.
From the Forum in Montreal, this is Hockey Night in Canada.
Got it. Canadians almost made it 3-0. And here is the reason why. It's Carboneau in front of the net with Hextall out. He flips the puck. Follow the bouncing puck. Hextall does. And he hangs on.
Oh, oh. Canadians again in possession. Swoboda, a nice pass for Smith. He stick handles away from Howe. Lemieux going in there with him. At the line and out. And it's a sharp call at the blue line. Offside.
Scott Mellamy's had a feisty evening so far. The second-year rookie out of the University of Wisconsin. Clashed briefly with Claude Lemieux in the first couple of minutes of the game, and right there had another brief set to with Peter Svoboda. And now he's going
with Nyland.
Chris Nyland and Mellenby before they even dropped the puck on the faceoff. So I don't know, Nyland maybe figured this guy has decided to take out a couple of my guys or has made motions that way, so maybe I'll try to set him straight.
Young Mellenby has
done all right.
Kind of made a name for himself. He can handle himself, and he's taking on one of the heavyweights in the league now, and he's doing pretty well. Nyland knows he hasn't got what you call a rookie in this type of a situation. McPhee won't reach this pass. Crossman back in his own zone. Now it's fed ahead by Huffman to center ice, and Brown in with a shot. Scores! That has happened before to Patrick Roy, but he got his glove on it that time and did not hang on to it.
The controversial Dave Brown, one of the shortest blades of a stick that any player in the NHL. He cuts it off a bit, helps him handle the puck. They say he loses something in the shot. Well, he didn't lose too much in this one, from right at the blue line. And all you can say is that Patrick Roy was not totally prepared for it. Got the glove on it, and it got away from him. And that's a large one for the Philadelphia Flyers, because it makes it a one-goal hockey game.
Now Chelios knocks it down, and he's away again. Chelios coming up there, trying to go in. Not much room, though, along the boards. Howe had him covered. The two players fall to the ice. Play continues and gets out to center ice. Chelios and Howe are bumping down there, and Hextall wants to leave the net. And finally, the play is called. Boy, they're heated up tonight.
Got through the first six, almost 7 minutes with only one whistle, but we've had a few of them now. And
the puck comes to him, though. Skrudland goes in to help. Skrudland now is checked by Crossman. Eklund, number nine, on the boards. Naslund going in, trying to knock it loose, and he gets it. Naslund out front! Rebound! Scramble, and down goes Hextall. And a penalty is coming up against Philadelphia. And might be more than one penalty before this is over.
Notice in the middle of that scrum, Brian Skrudland of the Canadiens minus his helmet. And he was the one who kept the puck alive. He took a hammering along the board. And just when it appeared as though Van Helleman was going to play the blow the play down, the puck came loose.
Canadiens pass at the center. Skrudland and Nyland coming in. McPhee was in on the right wing, and he's offside.
Over 18,000 here tonight. That will likely be the case as well this coming Wednesday when the Boston Bruins come to town. Chris Nyland's favorite team to play against, the Canadiens in Boston the next night. But I was told tonight that the toughest ticket of the year, oh, look out, we got Nyland going over to the bench.
Brown.
He is.
Of Philadelphia, at the bench, was standing up. A stormy situation, Dick. Well, these two.
And Nyland wasn't just going by the bench. He got in trouble at the bench in Calgary a couple of weeks ago, skating by, and somebody grabbed his stick, although he may have sort of leaned it toward the bench to begin with. And a hassle ensued. It's missing, but the ticket situation. They claim that maybe the toughest ticket of the season is for the game here next Saturday night. Is it because the New York Rangers are coming to town? Well, partly, but mainly because Michel Bergeron.
30 seconds left on the power play. 2-1, Montreal leading. Here's Naslund to Chelios. There's the shot, and Hextall is up to beat from that distance. Hextall is out pushing the Montreal player, Claude Lemieux, who is in the crease area.
But they get very, very upset, and right here, Lemieux, of course, he likes to do things, but that was just bang, bang, the whistle going, and Hextall shoves the big glove in the visor of Claude Lemieux just to let him know that he wasn't too thrilled with the whole thing. Close-up look at the action in the goal crease. And somehow, Bob, whenever Hextall's around like there, there's always a little more action than with other goaltenders. Extracurricular guy. And you saw there Ryan Walter getting the love tap across the back of the leg.
Canadiens have killed another penalty. Perfectly. Mellenby now. The shot blocked in front. Mellenby again. One after it near the line, and the Canadiens get it out. Carbonneau with Lemieux coming in. Carbonneau at the line. A great play. Goal!
Now watch Hextall. He is upset on interference. Here he goes. Both Bob Gainey and Claude Lemieux headed straight for the net on that play. And Hextall squawked him at Helleman. Should he have been upset? You be the judge. Don't think either Canadian player was what you can call in the crease area. Carbonneau gets his ninth of the year. Hextall gets a new stick.
Canadians do not move it out. Shot from the line by Smith was stopped and a scratch starts. That's Corson and Greg Smith. And another scrap starting with Derek Smith.
Two Smiths playing for Philadelphia. S-M-Y-T-H. Derek Smith is I-T-H. He's fighting with Mike Lawler. Boy, this just was a sudden outburst, wasn't it? We got two of them going at the same time. No, folks, this isn't pregame replay from the playoffs. This is happening tonight on the 9th of January, 88. Shane Corson in the middle of it there, number 27 against Greg Smith. And that one is over. And I guess the other one is over, too. Bob, this is giving us a little bit of everything, is it not, tonight? All the way from Ron Hextall's goal crease, out.
Ludwig was a late scratch for the Canadiens. There's Hextall touching the puck, and as Dick just mentioned, they're down now to four defensemen and another scrap, and it's going to be Nylund and Brown. Now, you talk about heavyweight.
It's been a pretty good hockey game. In fact, it's been a terrific hockey game. Suddenly, we get all of this.
The linesmen are poised. The referee, Andy Van Helman, making sure that other players are back near the blue line and let these two go.
Van Helman just turned his back as if to say, oh, come on, you guys. Skated away from it for a while. Let them do their thing. So we got two more players who are going to be gone for at least five. All of this happening in the final minute and 40 seconds or thereabout of the second period, with the Canadiens holding a 3-1 lead. Well, I guess if you're going to put the finger on two chaps who would get together in that fashion, Bob, you might say Brown and Nylund. And there they were. Well, we have more penalties called, and after that fast beginning we had to the game from the clock standpoint, this second period has dragged up. There's been a couple of hockey games in this building that have almost been finished by this time. So Nylund and Brown, who have been there before, are on the penalty sheets now because of fighting.
For fighting at 18 minutes 29 seconds.
Chalios into the last minute of the period, and offside is called at the Philadelphia line. Gainey was in ahead.
Sutter and Mamesso are making as if they want to go. Mamesso dropped a stick and one glove. Sutter skated away from him, and the Flyers, I think on a line change now, have more than the normal complement of six players on the ice. They've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They've got 7 up front. And this whole thing just now starts to drag down and drag along. Every time we get a whistle, we get something like this. Elsewhere, the Penguins have started to come back.
And only 35 seconds left in this period. Chalios back. Looking over his shoulder, he saw two Flyers come in. Here's Howe. He can't get a shot on a sharp angle. Now he centers it. It'll go to Samuelson at the blue line. He'll flip it in. Flyers would love a goal here late in the period. And they score! With only 20 seconds left, it was driven home by Poulin. Left unchecked in front of the net. And it's a brand new game again. Philadelphia within one. Crossman takes it at his own blue line. Cinesalo dropping it back. Crossman to Poulin. Poulin's rink wide pass. Cinesalo shoots, goal!
Flyers tie it. They just kept coming in this third period.
And the Canadiens shoot it down the ice. No icing, so we're going to overtime here at the Forum in Montreal. And the goaltenders get ready for sudden death overtime. I'm Bob Cole with Dick Irvin.
Here's Poulin going in, set it up, and McPhee had it tipped away. McPhee was flattened then as he tried to pick it up. Craven ran into him.
So the checking, you would imagine, is very close, but now Philadelphia in there. Down goes Patrick Waugh to stop it, with Poulin nearly jamming it in.
Fine work by Sutter behind the net to dig it out, and Patrick Waugh just looked down, and there it was. And there goes the siren to end this hockey game, and it ends in a tie. Hockey Night in Canada returns in just a moment.